Welcome back to Omni Calculator. Today we're going to talk about the displacement calculator. In 90 seconds, I'm going to tell you what it does, how to use it, why would you want to use it, and give you an example with a little twist there. So load up the questions and the timer starts now. Displacement is a tricky concept because it talks about the difference between where you start and where you finish a trip, for example, but it doesn't take into account the path that took you there. In physics, this is widely used, and in the real world, we don't use it as much, but it's easy to understand. Between New York and New Jersey, there is 55 miles in a straight line. That's the displacement. But the distance traveled depends on what route you take. It can take as little as 70 miles, or it can take thousands of them if you take a detour to Los Angeles, for example. Now that we understand this displacement, we can talk about the calculator and how to use it. It has three different modes to calculate displacement. One assuming constant velocity between the two points. The other one assuming constant acceleration, so you start at one velocity and gradually get up to a different one. And the last one is through a combination of different velocities in segments. And the fields will appear in that mode as you need them. All of these modes assume you travel in a straight line for simplicity. And that's why using this calculator for real-world applications is a bit limited, and it's much more useful, and actually it really, really works for solving your physics homework or exercises. Now onto the example, which I promised to have a twist, and is that we're not going to calculate displacement, we're going to calculate other fields because our calculators allow us to calculate any fields we want. So let's say we're going from New York to New Jersey, we already know the displacement, 55 miles, and it took us an hour and a half by car. If we travel in a straight line, we would have to do that in 36.6 miles per hour. And I didn't manage to get the units, but I'm going to count this as a W. I think we explained as much as we could. If you need more information or if you want to read it at your own pace, there's a link in the video description to the calculator with the text next to it. And if you enjoyed this video and found it useful, hit the like button, share it with a friend, subscribe to the channel, and maybe watch another one. I recommend this one. YouTube wants you to see that one. Either of them is going to be good. I'm going to be here in the next one. So until then, bye.